I'm Carl from Earth Crisis, and you're watching the Bare Bones Music Network. It was definitely a fun show. This is the first time we played Kentucky in years.
Yeah.
So it was awesome to have such a positive response and see kids travel too. I mean, kids came from Indiana and down from Ohio too.
Yeah.
That was great too, because we saw a lot of people that were here at the last show we played here 10 years ago. So it was a nice welcome back.
I want them to know how powerful this is. And how much better it's made my life. So I want to share it with people. And, you know, it's not like we preach with these lyrics. Mm-hmm. If you look at the lyrics and take time to read the words to a song like Asphyxiate or Killing Brain Cells or Wither, they're descriptions of things I saw people experience.
I think the message of Straight Edge with Earth Crisis is great because, I think it's important to forward. Because, drug abuse and alcohol abuse can affect people in every social circle. I mean, in every single social situation you can think of, I know I can think of. And now it's, as our band continues, we're on our second or third generation of fans. Like, we see kids whose parents were into our band now,
yeah.
Which is, it's kind of great, you know what I mean? But... You know what I mean? That danger's still there, you know what I mean?
Sure.
So I think the message is more important than ever.
You know, the move to Century Media has made a lot of sense. They've followed through on everything they said they were going to do, and you know, we could kind of in a way test the water with some of our friends' bands who've been on the label for a while and are very happy with how the label's treated them and how they've, you know, promoted their albums, like Sworn Enemy and Terror, for instance. So you know we've heard more yeses than nos for things we've asked for. You know, they made vinyl for us. They let us do a 7-inch on a straight edge label called Seventh Dagger out of North Carolina. And we've made a video, and we're going to make two more. And they're you know, pushing the single To Ashes on satellite radio. So, you know, we're really pleased with the energy and effort Century Media is putting into this album.
We like how they treat their bands, and you know, they give us a lot of creative freedom, so we're happy right now. So
this tour is great. We're out on the road in the U.S. and in Canada with Walls of Jericho, Reign Supreme. We had Blood Stand Still, a great band from California, out with us for a couple weeks. They did a great job, and we're seeing old fans come back, and we're seeing a younger generation who grew up with our albums but has actually never seen the band before. So that's an awesome thing to have happen.
It's just great to be on the road. It's great for Earth Crisis to be on the road, supporting a new record. Like he said, meeting lots of new fans that maybe just saw old videos of us on YouTube or something.
Yeah.
I think overall, you know, the majority of the reviews I've seen in magazines and the stuff that Scott showed me online has been very, very positive. And like I said earlier, you know, it seems like the fans are definitely taking to the album. We've got older guys that are coming back and younger guys that are showing up. So I'm definitely going to, you know, mark this one up in the win column so far.
Yeah. I think we've been doing really well. I mean, You know, I've seen the reviews and they've been really good. Even people that you can tell they don't want to give us a good review, they kind of have to. So. Control through fear. Let the chaos rage into disorder. Prepare us for marionettes. Unseen masters hand. The jammers crack the pillars till they release them link by link. The chains constrict.
I would say, you know, from day one, Earth Crisis was, you know, exactly what it is now and will always be, and that's a vegan straight edge band. You know, we all came out of the ruins of other groups that kind of caved in. And we wanted to do a band where, you know, it wasn't just about, you know, trying to play shows or write songs, where it was, you know, a group of friends who shared similar beliefs and we would kind of forward them through, you know, the vehicle of music. Yeah, and you know, it's neat too, because I've read a lot of books about other bands, rock bands and metal bands, and it's amazing to me, like, how abusive some of these members are to each other, and, you know, they'll take their fans for granted or the band itself for granted. I mean, we've never done that, you know. I mean, so I'm thankful for our fans and for, you know, the friendships that we have. It's amazing. Well, there's a lot of firsts. For Earth Crisis, I think we were the first straight edge band to ever travel from the U.S. to Japan or to South America. I think to this day we may hold the record to as far as playing to the largest audience. That was when we played in 2000 in Bogota, Colombia, at a festival called Rock in the Park. There was hundreds of thousands of people there. It's like one of the biggest metal fests in that part of the world. So that was incredible victory. You know, we've been on satellite radio. We've made videos. I think so far we've been to like 24 foreign countries. And this is a band, you know, that, like Eric said, you know, I refuse to let it die, because I believe in the idea, and I think the idea can work, and I think it's a message that needs to reach people at all costs. So, and I think that there's a lot of amazing new straight edge bands out there. You know, I see this whole thing as like a team effort, literally. You know, there's One Choice, there's Sacred Pledge, there's Black Outrage, Maroon, Heaven Shall Burn, Asunto, Nueva Ethica. I mean, there's straight edge bands all over the world at this point. You know, there's Loyal to the Grave from Japan, and, you know, the quality's there musically with all these bands, and a lot of these guys are in their 20s or their 30s, so, you know, they're passing the test of time. They're proving that, you know, they can live true to the lifetime commitment. So I see straight edge as stronger than it's ever been now. And, you know, collectively, all these bands, Earth Crisis, you know, we're definitely reaching younger people. It's a lot easier to access hardcore nowadays, too. I mean, a kid can go online and read lyrics. They can go online and read interviews or watch interviews or, you know, listen to music. So I think hardcore, while right now it may be somewhat more factionalized than it was in the past, it's very strong. Yeah, there's been literally, you know, hundreds and hundreds of straight edge bands since 1981. And, you know, the washout rate is probably 90% when it comes to, you know, people breaking their edge or actually selling out, you know, and then mocking the idea of straight edge and straight edge people, which to us is sickening. This isn't, you know, a reunion. It's definitely a rebirth. The new album To the Death is out, and the next one is, you know, we're starting to work on that. We're already starting to write new songs, so there's, you know, the calendar's full. We're, you know, we're basically on a world tour.